The 2016 version of the International Manufacturing and Technology Show came to McCormick Place. This is one of the largest industrial trade shows in the world. There were over 2,000 exhibiting companies. 2 years ago, I visited the show to see Strati, the world's first 3D printed car. This year, my mission was to get a ride in Olli, the 3D printed self-driving bus. Hi, this could only be Rides with Chuck. In this video, we find out about Olli, the 3D printed self-driving bus, and we go for a ride.
But first, let's hear from Local Motors Head of Product Development.
So my name is Alex Fiechter, and I'm Head of Product Development. So I run the department that has the resources that are actually doing the development and engineering and styling. The actual program has been going on since early 2015. When we started the Urban Mobility Challenge on our co-creative platform online. But that was before the Olli was even a concept. That was really when the problem was first brought to the community to address. Then we really started working in earnest on the Olli really around the beginning of this year. So it's been about 6 months till the release of that prototype in June. Again, Olli being autonomous has to have quite a few sensors on board, and redundancy is of great importance to us. The sensors that you see lined out on this one, this is the very first prototype we ever built. So this being the first one doesn't have all the representative equipment on it that we'll have in the production ones. We'll really be going with a multi-sensor array with LiDAR going to approach radar and see what kind of performance we can get out of that too, and then visual as well. Plus we've got the haptic sensors for kind of goalkeepers, as it were, on the system. So on this one, you're really just working with LiDAR and the haptic right now, especially down here, because we don't have GPS really accessible inside like this.
How far down in the basement are we?
What are we? Are we two levels down, something like that? I mean, it's, we got a lot of metal above us, that's for sure. A lot of structure, so metal and concrete. But yeah, basically one of the biggest things for us is going to be about not just having a significant amount of overlap when it comes to the sensors that we spec, but then also being able to have a couple of different styles of sensors operating in the same area so that they can work as kind of check and balance to each other, not only for localization, but also for safety.
How fast can this vehicle go now?
Well, so this vehicle is capable of going a little bit faster than this, but as far as where it's going to be operating primarily at, so really most of the zones are going to be between 15 and 20 miles per hour, because you're talking about low speed neighborhoods or private campuses, things like that. As far as the program goes altogether, I would say really it's been it's more of an opportunity, but I would say this is maybe one of the most serious and one of the most integrated and multimedia examples for us of using DDM, having 3D printed parts on the car and then having second degree direct digital parts on the car with all the interior panels that we made through 3D printed tooling, to lacing that in with all of our other mediums that we work in as well, to create more of a finished result than some of the other things where we've done big expositions with a particular process or things like that. But again, we, it was kind of a welcome challenge, because we got to ask a lot of the questions that we've been wanting to ask for a while, but haven't had really the application and opportunity to put it on. So,
okay, then yeah, let's get you next to Alaric here. Jeremy, you're gonna stand. Let me ditch this coffee here. Okay, you're gonna stand, I'll sit here. We can take three here. Okay, hang on 1 second. All right, we're gonna do the first three.
Okay.
And then, oh, okay.
I think he's medium.
Yeah, can you, because he's gonna film this first ride with me, can you wait one or two rides?
Oh yeah.
It'll be going quick once we finally get going here. All right, so let's take a group of three.
Okay.
Okay, first three are coming.
Okay.
Okay. Cool. Well, should I sit here?
Yeah, right here. These three can fit three right here.
That's it?
Yep. All right, guys. Well, welcome to Olli. This is the world's first cognitive self-driving vehicle built by Local Motors. So here at IMTS, we're demoing what we can do with the vehicle. It's designed to work in dense urban areas and downtowns, or even places like college campuses or amusement parks to move people from one end to the other. And if a city like Chicago were to implement Olli service like in the downtown area, there would be a lot running around all at the same time, and you'd have an app on your phone where you'd be able to hail the Olli to come to you, enter a destination, and take you where you need to go. So we're getting ready to start pilot programs late this year, early next year in the Las Vegas area, and then also Miami and Florida. We have another one of these vehicles. This is the first one that's ever been built that you're riding in now. And we have one more in Berlin, and then we're ramping up production later this year in the Phoenix area where we have a facility, and we should have 6 to 8 more by the end of the year, and then we'll ramp up from there next year. So I'm the director of public relations and content at Local Motors. So it's my job to tell the world about Olli, and it's been a lot of fun. So at IMTS this week, we've had a couple challenges with the vehicle just being mostly underground here in the convention center. That messes with some of the mapping and the GPS technology. There you go. Thank you guys.
Thanks for the ride.
Hope you enjoyed the ride. Yep.
Thank you, everybody.
Well, we've worked through it. We're giving people a lot of rides. We probably gave people a few hundred rides yesterday, and we'll do more today. So we get people on roughly 5 at a time, take them around our track, tell them about the vision for Olli and what it's going to be. And we're going to ramp up production on the vehicle later this year. We'll probably build 6 to 8 more by the end of the year. Those will go into pilot programs. And then next year, we'll probably build somewhere in the neighborhood of 50 and start getting them out on the roads. We've had a ton of interest since we launched it in June.
I can't wait for one to come to my neighborhood.
Yeah, you know, ideally the way it's going to work, if like let's say you live in a dense urban area, like in a downtown like Chicago, if the city decided to you know, put into service a fleet of these, say in a couple square mile area, there'd be a lot of these rolling around, and there'd be an app on your phone similar to Uber or Lyft where you'd be able to hail the Olli and it would come to you and take you where you need to go. Now along the way, there might be some other people that you would pick up, and it would all be route optimized so each Olli knows where to go to get the right people and save time, because the long-term goal really is that, you know, we want to be able to get cars off the roads to an extent and lessen congestion. And then if you look outside of the urban core example, if you think about places like college campuses, corporate campuses, amusement parks, any sort of place where you need to move people from one end to the other, Olli is a really great, what we call first and last mile solution. And even if you go back into to the urban core example, if you live in certain cities, you know, say you're 2 or 3 miles from a transit line, that's a tough thing to get to every day. But if you can have something come to you, right to the doorstep, and take you to that public transit line, it can change the jobs you kind of take, and it can change your whole career.